designers, together with Dutch and Indonesian universities, have all raised it and given new viewpoints to the dilemma of rapid urbanization. So combining different perspectives creates competitive innovation. Urban designs and agricultural planning separately have not succeeded in keeping the data in the Costa, Rocola, and the data. A new approach, combining local wisdom with global knowledge, integrates research with design experience and make a big difference. Applications. And I would like now to give the floor to the creator and designer of the exhibition, Mr. Harold.
Actually, I'm only a creator of this exhibition because the designs were made by Sigi Kuzman Jere, the artist who known by some of us speaking in the world. Anyway, I'm a curator. And it's called landscapes. Now, commonly people associate landscapes mostly with natural, virgin landscapes, kind of landscapes that you see in the National Geographic or in the Culture Channel, or beautiful beautiful BBC documentaries. The kind of landscapes that I'm interested in are the cultural landscapes. Beautiful environment needs a lot of creativity to reach this. I think it's very interesting. In fact, I like to go through it. I like to walk through it. Last weekend I was walking through the vineyards along the Rhine in Germany. I love to take my bicycle and go out to the Polders in the Netherlands. And all this brings back memories of my childhood of walking through the Salas in Goa and around the island. Cultural landscapes are pre-definition landscapes in transition because they are made by men. It's always changing. Sometimes these transitions, these transformations, happen so fast that it seems like the landscape has gone. It's getting further. Moving into the landscape. I think that although this is a very good idea, it's also about the productivity. I think that you should make use of the capacity of the landscape. The landscape has big capacity. A couple of years ago, let's say 10 years ago, my office was asked to look at regional landscape, regional architecture. Actually, at that point, we said, well, maybe you should not look at regional architecture, because the reason why you do it is basically not architecture, it's about urban planning. There's a policy in the Netherlands that you should draw a red line around the cities and around the cities in the cities. This capacity to kind of incorporate urban program is also a capacity of the Indonesian cultural landscapes. In fact, it's this capacity which I think generated one of the first internationally used Indonesian words, Desakota, is a word which is Indonesian, but it's also Dutch, it's also French, it's also Australian, or English, and it's connected, so it's a very important element. However, in modern times, the management which was traditionally done by all the villages together is kind of disrupted. There's a lot of new things happening. So, Shaw from Bangalore, together with William Verbe from IHP in Delft, developed schemes to renew his commitments to the water management. Now, very proud in their culinary tradition. But the French also link it to their landscape. And they do a lot. Like we in Europe, we have to do a lot to allow the French to bring a lot of subsidies to the landscape. No, because it's a beautiful landscape. We want to show it to everybody. And we are very grateful for the Erasmus Huis that it's being made possible. We are very grateful for the technical service of the Erasmus Huis that we helped build this. And I think I should once again mention Sigi, Kuzman Jere, as the designer of the exhibition, and he works as the designer of the layout of the panels.
first shout out.